In my last video, we have learned mechanical properties and optical properties of colloids. Today, we are going to study the important property, electrical properties of colloids. Okay? The colloidal particles are electrically charged. The charge of the colloidal particles may be positive or negative. Okay? The examples for positively charged salt. Hydroxide salts like aluminum hydroxide salt, AlOH trisalt, ferric hydroxide salt, FeOH trisalt. And the examples for negatively charged salt, metallic salts like platinum salt, silver salt, gold salt, and metallic sulfide salts like arsenic sulfate salt, cadmium sulfate salt. Okay. The presence of charge is responsible for stability of colloids. The same charged colloidal particles, the positively charged or negatively charged colloidal particles, repel each other and it prevents the aggregation of colloidal particles. Okay, and okay, students. The presence of charge is responsible for stability of colloids. Okay, then, the next topic. Origin of charge on colloids. Colloidal particles acquire charge. Okay, either by frictional electrification or by preferential adsorption of ions from solution. Okay. Number one, by frictional electrification. Okay. It is believed that colloidal particles acquire charge by the mutual rubbing of dispersed phase particles, that is colloidal particles, with the particles of dispersion medium. And number two, the colloidal particles acquire charge by preferential adsorption of ions from solution. Okay, students, the colloidal particles adsorb only those ions, okay, from the solution which are common with their own lattice ion. Okay, the colloidal particles adsorb only those ions preferentially, the important term, preferential adsorption. Okay, the ion which are common with their own lattice ion. Okay, that means the colloidal particles adsorb preferentially with the common ion from their solution. This is called preferential adsorption. Okay, for example, then one mole of AgNO3 is treated with one mole of potassium iodide solution. Ki solution forms one mole of AgI and KNO3. Okay, here one mole of AgNO3 reacts completely with one mole of Ki. Okay, there is no AgNO3 molecule and Ki molecule in that reaction mixture. Then, if we add excess potassium iodide solution to AgNO3 solution. Okay, then that solution may consist of large number of excess K plus ion and or unreacted K plus ion and unreacted I minus ion. In this case, please listen, preferential adsorption takes place. That means the AgI particles adsorb the common ion I minus ion from the solution, I minus ion from the solution, and the AGI particles become negative.
Yes.
Okay. Here AGI particles and so on. I minus I out from solution when we add excess K solution, and the AGI particle becomes negatively charged. But negatively charged colloidal particle is formed. Okay, and the counter ion K plus ions remain in the solution, and the dispersion medium acquire equal but opposite charge to that of colloidal particle. Here colloidal particle acquire negative charge, but dispersion medium acquire positive charge. Okay, then when we add excess AgNO3 solution to KI solution, the AgI particles adsorb AgI plus ion from the solution, AgI plus ion from the solution, and the AgI particle becomes positively charged. The leftout ion, the counter ion, NO3 minus remains in dispersion medium, and dispersion medium acquire negative charge. Okay. Okay. Usually, a particle adsorbs common ion from the solution. Common ion from the solution, a particle adsorbs a common ion from the solution. This adsorption is called the preferential adsorption. Okay, in this case, AGI particle adsorbs I minus ion from the solution, the common ion, I minus ion from the solution. Okay, and in the second case, AGI particle adsorbs AGI plus ion, the common ion from the solution, when excess AgNO3 is added. Okay, this is called the preferential adsorption. Okay, then please listen. Here two layers are formed. Okay, here AgI particle adsorb AgI plus ion from the solution. The colloidal particle adsorb a common ion from the solution and forms a layer called a fixed layer. The counter ion NO3 minus remains in the solution. It acts as mobile layer. Okay, here also two layers are formed, fixed layer and mobile layer. Okay, then please listen. Yes, so that means when one type of ions of electrolyte are adsorbed on the surface of colloidal particle, it forms fixed layer and it attracts the counter ion. Okay, the first thing is the counter ion is K plus, and the second case the counter ion is NO3 minus. Okay, from dispersion medium, which is called mobile layer, the double layer of opposite charges thus formed is called Helmholtz double layer. Okay, these two layers are called Helmholtz double layer. Then next important term, theta potential or electrokinetic potential. A potential difference exists between this mobile layer and fixed layer. Okay, this potential difference is called theta potential. Okay, students, then I am going to discuss the important electrical property of colloid, that is electrophoresis. The phenomenon of existence of charge on colloid is shown by electrophoresis. Okay, the phenomenon of existence of charge on colloid is shown by electrophoresis. What is meant by electrophoresis? Okay, here a colloidal solution, it may be arsenic sulfide salt. We know arsenic sulfide salt, negatively charged salt. Okay, it's taken in a YouTube it is fitted with a 2 platinum electrode. Then what will you observe when high voltage is applied? When high voltage is applied, the negatively charged arsenic sulfate particle move towards the positively charged sword, and this electrode gets discharged. Then coagulation or aggregation takes place. Okay, and the electrode coagulation or aggregation takes place. Okay, then if you take ferric hydroxide salt is positively charged salt. The positively charged ferric hydroxide particles move towards negative electrode. Okay, negative electrode, cathode, and coagulation takes place at that electrode. Then what is called the electrophoresis? The phenomenon of movement of colloidal particles towards oppositely charged electrodes by the application of electric field. Okay, students, goodbye, study well.